Welcome to the DMEXCO 2019 here in Cologne. It's a pleasure having you. I always ask the same question at the beginning. Who are you and what do you do?
Sounds good. Thank you. So my name's Sean O'Connor. I'm from Microsoft. I've been working in our ad business for over 12 years now. I'm an American guy with an Irish name who is fortunate enough to live in Ireland. And so I've spent the last 6 years leading both sales and marketing teams here in Europe.
And we pre-discussed, you're also a Boston Celtics fan.
You grew up a Larry Bird fan. Bird in the 80s was about as good as it got.
So the speaker before had a Celtics head on, so we like that. Great. Microsoft advertising. When you look at what we perceived, who is moving the market, you talk about Facebook, you talk about Amazon lately especially. Yep. But as usual with the big four companies, Microsoft definitely has a say in that. Can you describe the nature, size of your business a little bit more? What do you do at Microsoft Advertising?
For sure. So we've built a very large advertising business over many years. At this point in time, Bing, our search engine, was launched 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. And so we continue to learn, we continue to make it a more profitable business for Microsoft, and really fueled by AI. Bing for a long time has been Microsoft's largest AI application, and it's been a place where Microsoft has been able to learn, and we've been able to teach the rest of Microsoft a lot of things about artificial intelligence.
That's really interesting because in my perception, I would have thought it's the other way around, right? You have all the desktop installation, you interact a lot on the business side with users, and there's a very profitable business through the license revenue, through the software, through the business applications. Is it really that way that Bing and the work you do teaches them versus they teaching you? How's the interaction in the company usually?
Think about the billions of queries and you think about the amount of data that we have. And really, the modern AI is driven by three things. It's driven by access to cloud computing, it's driven by advances in algorithms and machine learning, and it's driven by proliferation of data, right? And so Bing has tremendous amounts of data, and we're able to use that data really to help our clients to reach a diverse audience, to reach an audience that we think is unique and is very valuable to them.
Okay. So when you go into a conversation with a big advertiser and you're interacting and you're showing all these examples, and there's always kind of probably the elephant in the room, what does Google do, what's Facebook do, what's Amazon doing? How do you differentiate yourself? What's your argument that a dollar spent with you is a dollar better spent than on another digital platform out there?
For sure. So I mentioned diverse audience. So we have over 20% market share here in Germany on a PC perspective. So we do believe that the audience is unique and that they have high buying power. So that's the first one. The second one is we have amazing teams. We have teams that really care. And then the final thing that we tell our clients is that we're doing our best to make it easy on them. We know that the life of a modern marketer is incredibly challenging, from getting the right message to the right audience at the right time, and you've got amazing amounts of data, you have more tools and more ad tech at your disposal, and we spend a lot of our time looking for ways to make it easy on our clients to reach our audience.
Okay, so there is a lot more to it than just the data analysis, which you described is already quite a significant chunk. It allows you to analyze data really well, present it to your clients, but then there are added services that you do to differentiate yourself in the market to show that it's more efficiently spent. Is that a fair summary of where you go?
Yeah.
All right, cool. So in the advertising market, what amazes me is that the ways, the formats I combine with data in terms of my analytical capability to display advertising, they seem to increase every day. I mean, I looked at Facebook a while back and they said they have roughly 200 different advertising formats by now. If you look at how many display formats and so on Amazon has, it's amazing. I'm sure you go with the same development that the kind of inventory you have for advertising is constantly increasing. How do you, in your added services, explain to a customer that there is such a wide variety of possibilities in terms of displaying their ads? How do you kind of create order in a world of chaos of a lot of different choices they can take?
Yeah, so we do it in two ways. And I mentioned the first one was really about simplification. And so we are trying to make it easy and reduce the friction to take what you're doing with other platforms and bring that to Bing. to bring it to Microsoft advertising. That's one. The second one is we're absolutely interested and really working hard to innovate on that experience. Mm-hmm. And so Microsoft Shopping Campaigns, I think, is a good example of us really focusing on a specific vertical. We're laser focused on adding more value to our retail clients. Microsoft Shopping Campaigns has launched in the Netherlands very recently. It's already live in Germany and France and the UK and US, Canada, Australia. And it's coming soon to many of the other markets in Europe. But to me, this is really a must-buy for a retailer looking to reach a new audience in the lead up to the holiday season.
What's a product? Can you describe it a little more?
The Microsoft Shopping Campaigns allows our clients to bring their product feeds into search to display both a picture but also text, and really a procured retail experience in the search results.
Okay, so making it more visible helps the consumer make the right choice, works better through that format. To go through with it. Interesting, we talked about inventory and the different formats that's being displayed. Mm-hmm. There also is a lot more inventory as we go along for competing for shifting, but still largely the same advertising budgets. Mm-hmm. So again, the same question, if there is a world of unlimited inventory, how do I go in and find which display ad should go where? If you talk about programming advertising, mm-hmm. Where my product should be displayed and where it shouldn't be displayed.
Right.
How do you approach these client questions? How do you support them in that aspect?
Yeah, I think it's really about starting somewhere, right? Mm-hmm. And so you've got to start with a broad audience and then really refine that over time. And so this mantra of really testing and always be testing and finding new ways to test and rotate, you know, whether you're rotating your ad copy or you're rotating your placements or you're refining your audience, the amount of features that we have at our clients' disposal to test and refine and to really increase the ROI that they have on their campaigns, that's what we're after.
Okay, great. And I also have to ask an industry question. So you have the search engine market and the ad market that comes with it. Mm-hmm. And I think you're probably in a fairly well-established environment. You might shift here, you might shift there in terms of percentage of searches to which search engine they go. On comes Amazon 2 years ago, mm-hmm. Opening their advertising platform and really going after performance budgets, which I would very closely link to the search budgets.
For sure. What
has been your experience of the market development in the last 2 years? Because from how I would see it, I would say, okay, the major other player in the market always used to be Google, and then you had Microsoft, maybe a range of other players, and they would always compete against each other. But now you're kind of saying, okay, well, hopefully that person sticks with search and doesn't put all his money into the Amazon channel. Is that something you see in the industry happening?
Yeah, we see retailers coming to us and asking for consulting, right? They're looking to work with us from a cloud computing perspective. They're looking to work with us across our entire stack. So as I mentioned before, we're super focused on retail and we see a tremendous amount of opportunity to enable every retailer really to be successful, to find new audiences, to transform digitally, to find more e-commerce. So it's a place where we're innovating, and we recently acquired Promote IQ. The acquisition is really only about a month old at this point in time, but it's a real signal for us that we're looking to continue to innovate. They're already a very successful, they're a bright bunch of people, they've got a strong business plan, and so you'll see more from us in the future in the retail space in order to help other retailers really be successful.
So I'm summarizing that you have to go out there, and even though Amazon is arguably closer to the point of consumption than the search engine is, you still can, through acquisitions, through supporting the client better, make a good argument why a dollar spent with you is still a really good idea for retailers, for advertisers, to get the consumer to purchase their products. So thank you very much for the insights into Microsoft and what you're doing around Bing and why advertising with you is a good idea. At the end of each interview, I always ask the question, why So many companies seem to be struggling with digital transformation, and I'm asking each of the person I get the chance to talk to today for their two cents on the issue. Why do you think there's a strongly felt struggle with companies to transform themselves into the digital world?
Yeah, I think they're struggling with it because it's really hard, right?
I mean, that's
I agree. That's the reality, and especially for entrenched businesses that have robust processes, they have robust systems. To transform digitally, they need really strong partners. They need to retool, whether it's through hiring new talent or preferably investing in their own workforce to say, we were good at this yesterday. The world is going to look different tomorrow. And so how can you help your employees to retool, to get smart in data, to get smart in artificial intelligence and how to leverage that? That's really the biggest thing that I think about is from a workforce perspective. But beyond it being hard, it's also a journey, right? This isn't something that companies are going to solve by, you know, deciding to do it tomorrow, right? It's something that they have to have.
It's a marathon, not a sprint.
You have to have a plan for it. You have to be deliberate. You're going to learn. You're going to fail. You're going to learn again. And so that's really how I think about it.
I love the answer. I think there's a quite an optimistic note to it, and I think that's a good note to end the discussion. Thanks very much for the talk
here.
Thank
you. It's great. Thanks.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.